Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1778, Add Variables to Recorded Macro. All right, hey, today's question is sent in by Matt. Matt is coming up to speed, getting really good with the macro recorder, but now he needs to do a few things that the macro recorder can't do. And so we have this report, we get this report every day, and there's a different number of records, and Matt can deal with that. He's gotten really good at dealing with the different number of records, but we want to be able to do other things, like add a summary table below the data. And to make that easier, it'd be good to have a couple of variables that we're going to add to the macro recorder. So here on the developer tab, I'm going to say that I want to record a macro. I'll just call it Matt Take One. And we'll store it in this workbook. Click OK. All right, now, relative reference should always be on. I turned that on before I started recording. 99% of your macros should have relative reference on. I'm going to build that summary table. The summary table wants to take all of the regions in column A. So from here, I'm going to do Control Shift Down Arrow. I'm going to Control C to copy that to the clipboard. Control Down Arrow. And then I'll go down three rows. Right two rows. And Control V to paste the whole region down there. And on the Data tab, I will do Remove Duplicates. Click OK. That way I know I have just the unique list of regions down there. All right, and then we want to build report showing revenue. All right, so here equals SUMIF. I know that I'm going to have to fix this in the macro, but let's see if we can get close at least. So we start here in A2, Control Shift Down Arrow, 4 is equal to, press the left arrow key, comma, and then up here D2, Control Shift Down Arrow, press F4. And I'm going to Control Enter to say in the same cell, double click the fill handle. To shoot that down. Now here there's only one region, but tomorrow there might be two regions or something like that. All right, so the first step is done. I have that summary table built with the macro recorder. I now need to go up and add totals. And to do that, I always want to go to cell A1. I don't want to go up 21 cells from where I am now because tomorrow I might be at a different spot. So I'm going to use the F5 key. This is a great way in a macro to say I always want to go to a specific spot. Click OK, and we'll do Control Down Arrow, that'll get me to the last row with data. One more time, we'll get me to the total row, total. And come over here, two cells, equals sum. Never use the auto sum here, by the way. The macro recorder will not record what you're trying to do. We're trying to go from C, $2. Would you ever type that $ in real life? No, but we're going to do it with the macro recorder because that will convince the macro recorder to do the right thing. Down to C17, the cell right above me, and that is a relative reference. And Control C. And Control V to the right. Okay, good. Let's stop recording. And now we're going to go take a look at the code. Okay, so we press Alt F11. Here's our workbook. There's our module. Double click. And there is the recorded code. All right, so now we're going to add in some variables to the recorded code. And one variable that I create in every single macro is something called final row. Final row is equal to cells. Rows.count, so in other words, go down to the very last row, comma 1, that's column A, press the N key and the XL up key and figure out what row that is. So that tells us the last row with data today. My total row is going to be equal to final row plus 1. The summary row is going to be equal to final row plus 3. And then the row count, because we have headings in row 1, is going to be equal to final row minus 1. All right, so now I have those four variables that I can use in the macro. And as I look through the macro, the first few lines here worked great. It selected everything that we have in column A. It went down three rows and two columns over. It did a paste, but then it hard-coded that we had data in rows C20 to C36, and that will not work. We have to fix that piece. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to say that we are in cells, summary row, comma, column 3, dot resize. Resize will take that starting cell, and it's actually going to be final row is the height, comma 1. So rather than doing active sheet dot range and hard coding that, we're going to use this that has two different variables, and we will use the rest of the recorded code for the second half of that line. This went up and put the revenue in. That should work. Next, we want to put the word revenue in. So let's change that. We'll say that that is in cells, summary row, minus 1, comma 4. We can get rid of this line. All right, then the next thing that's happening is we're putting in the SUMIF formula. And as I look at this, it's going from row 2, column 1 to row 17, column 1. They hard-coded that piece of that, and that's not good at all. So I'm going to create my formula is equal to, I just put quote, quote there, so I'm allowed to go to the next line and scoop this out here. I'm going to take everything between the quotes, control C, and bring this back, all right? And then I'm going to build this myself. So up to where it says row 17, I'm going to concatenate final row, ampersand, quotes, go back to what they had, column 1, R column, RC minus 1, column 4, that's good. But then here where we have 17, ampersand, final row, ampersand, quotes, get rid of 17, column 4. And so now that builds an R1C1 formula that will be flexible. It'll always go down to however many rows we happen to have that day. R1C1 is difficult to understand. I'm not going to cover that in this macro. But even without understanding it, just knowing that they had hard-coded row 17 before, now we've concatenated together a formula that'll work. The trick now is to get that formula into the right spot. So we already know that we put the heading. Let's see, we put the heading here. Summary row minus 1 in column 4. So I know it's going to be summary row, not minus 1, but starting in summary row, comma 4. And we're going to do dot resize. If I had more time, I would actually put in a variable to figure out how many rows we had today. I'm just going to make it be 3 rows tall, 1 column wide. Dot formula R1C1 is equal to my formula. It's too bad we don't have picture in picture anymore because you can't see where my eyes are looking. As I was typing that, I was looking down here, the formula.r1c1, so it's copying that property, but then using the formula that I built above. So we can now actually get rid of these parts here, and also this section goes away. All right, so we put the revenue heading in, we build the formula, and then put the formula in the right spot. From there on out, everything that we recorded should be fine. Here's where we go to A1, which is R1C1 in the language of the macro, do selection N down, put the total in, and I think at this point we're good to go, except for the fact that we're going to get a summary table that's always 3 regions high, and we should come back later and fix that. But I'm running short on time, so let's go back, Alt F11. Okay, so we'll come back here to a different day, start up in cell A1, and we will run the macro, Alt F8, Matt take 1, click run. And hey, it's remarkably close. We're putting this column, column 4, everything is going to the wrong spot. So let me erase what we've done here. We'll come back and take a look at our code, Alt F11. So down here in summary row, comma 4, summary row, the column 4, everything there needs to be adjusted down 1. And here, plus 1, those 2 changes. All right, let's go back and try it again. Alt F8, Matt take 1. Click run. Totals appear in the right spot. Always make sure they're going all the way up to D2. And we have the revenue table appearing with a total that matches. Everything looks good. All right. So it's tough to go from the macro recorder all of a sudden having to create these variables. But these variables will help you find the spots that when the macro recorder did something stupid, like hard code where that formula is, even though we had relative turned on, you can go in and patch those bits of the macro using these variables here. And it turns out that we never actually use total row in the macro, but that's okay. I'd rather just have it there, and then if I needed it, we know that we're good to go. Well, hey, I want to thank everyone for stopping by. I want to thank Matt for asking that question. Matt, good luck with the as you begin going from the macro recorder over to VBA. Hey, of course, this is a great time to remind you about the MrExcel.com/forum. What an amazing community of people there. They answer 30,000 questions a year. 10,000 of those questions are VBA questions. Just pop out there, start a new topic, say, hey, I'm trying to learn VBA. Here's my code. Can you help me out? And they will be happy to give you some pointers. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.